Shifting realities is actually quite easy if you understand how the mind works, because it is your mind that is creating your current reality. And so based on how you perceive reality and how you create reality using your mind, you're going to be stuck in certain pattern or keep on creating, perpetuating certain situation instead of creating the one that you actually really want. So to understand how you can change your reality if you don't like it, you must understand how your mind works, because this is the basis of how you create your own reality in your life right now. And so in this video, what we're gonna do is that we're gonna break down in a very simple way for you to understand how your mind perceives reality, creates reality, and what you can do to change that and create the life that you desire, okay? So we're gonna start straight away with this is you, okay? This little ugly drawing of a person here is you right now. So this is you, and right now in your life here, you have a certain set of result. Another word for that is that you're experiencing reality in a certain way. Your reality right now has a certain result. Yeah? The way of your health, how much money you're making, how happy you are, your level of confidence and happiness, your relationships, the place you live, the way you think, all those kind of things that you're creating in your life right now, we could say are your result. Now, you may be happy with a certain part of your life, and you may be unhappy or unfulfilled in certain other area of your life. Now, the question is often like, how do I change my result? Like, this is where people have goals and intention and things they want to create, change, and manifest, right? And we think that when I get those things, you know, then everything will be okay, then I'll feel better, then I'll feel fulfilled, then my life will be great. And that's really the essence that we're trying to capture, is that feeling of how we want to feel in our reality instead of how we are currently experiencing it. But let's backtrack a little bit. How do we actually create the result in the first place? So you see, the first thing is that we are always receiving information from our external reality, right? So the external world around us is constantly bombarding us with information through our five senses. So you can understand what is happening around you because you can see this video, you can hear me, you can touch the coffee or the coffee cup or the table or your clothes or your body. You can smell, you can taste, so you can experience the world around you in your reality through your five senses, okay? Now, what is happening next is actually very, very important, because this is crucial to understand. You see, so we are always receiving information through our external world. That is unavoidable, unless you live in a freaking cave somewhere and you live in the dark, and so there is nothing to receive, so to speak. You are always being bombarded with fuckloads of information every single instant, no matter what you do, especially in this day and age where we are bombarded by notification and distraction and social media and information everywhere around us. So you see, the mind here cannot comprehend everything that's happening all the time. If you were to consciously hold all the information that are coming to your mind right now, you would go insane, because there's just so much to understand. I mean, think about just what is happening inside your own body, all the sensations, right? And the weight of your body and the sound in the background and all those other things that are just happening around you. All of this will overwhelm you. So what your mind does is brilliant, is that your mind has a set of filters here. Subconscious filters that is going to filter that information before it goes into your conscious awareness. So what are those filters and why are they so important? Those filters are so important because they help you destroy, generalize, and delete information that are not relevant to you right now, so that you can consciously then just choose to focus on what's happening. So for example, you can delete what's happening around you so that you can just focus on this video and the information that are coming to you right now, right? So if there is any noise around you or people talking or your cars driving and so, your mind can kind of tune down all of those external noises to allow you to just focus on where you want to put your attention. That's why sometimes you're reading a book or you're scrolling on social media and you just don't hear people who talk around you. It's not that those noises are not there, but it's that those filters are kind of subconsciously, automatically tuning out what is not relevant on your point of focus and attention right now, okay? But it goes much deeper and much more important is that because of what those filters have, because of the content of the programming of your subconscious mind, it's going to filter out based on all the programs that you have. Meaning, what are those programs? We're talking about your beliefs, we're talking about your values, we're talking about your sense of identity, all those core beliefs that you attach about yourself, right? Your identity, personality, the way you grew up, all those cultural beliefs that have been given to you from the moment you were born all the way to today, right? That's why every single person experiences reality and perceives reality in a different way. So you can be faced to an external event along with 1,000 other people, and every single one of them would experience that event in a different way. Why is that? Because they have different set of filters. For example, what is good for you might not be good for another person, right? And this is often the source of so many conflicts in our world today, is that I think this is a good way of doing things, and another person will be like, no, this is a fucked up way, we should do it this way, that is better, right? So nobody is either right or wrong, but it's because the filters that you have, the beliefs that you have subconsciously control a majority of your external reality. And this is important, why? Because as that information comes to you through your five senses and it's being filtered in a moment, what is happening next is that it's creating a thought in your mind, or what we could call a meaning. What do I mean by that? Well, this here is actually how you perceive reality. What does it mean to you, that event? You're watching this video right now, okay? Do you find this video interesting? I'm learning, there's some very interesting concept there. Or perhaps you don't like the voice, you don't like the quality of the video, you don't like this and that, whatever. So you see, however you experience this is because of the filters that you have. And that is creating a thought in your mind, a meaning. Logically, this is what this situation means. It's good, it's bad, it's great, it's not good. So, for example, now, what can happen here? Let's break it down in terms of how your current results are affecting your reality. Because let's say you see your bank account, okay? And your bank account is showing, again, it's in the red or it's in low. And you know that bills are coming right up. So you're receiving that information through seeing the picture. Now you perceive this through your filters and you go like, oh my God, it's never enough. Oh my God, it's happening again. Oh my God. And it brings all those feelings of lack. So you're starting to create a story here about what this situation means. The next thing that happened is equally important, because now you start to feel a certain way, right? So the thought creates the feeling. And now you start to feel it in your body. Maybe there's anxiety that arises. You start to worry. You start to overthink. You start to notice, oh my God, what am I going to do? Oh my God, this situation is so fucked up. I need to manifest money. I need to find a way. So it creates that feeling. And that feeling usually reinforces the thoughts that you have. So once you start to feel anxious, you start to have more anxious thoughts, right? And you start to go into that loop. But that's not it. Because next part is equally crucial. The moment you start to think and feel, and pay attention because this is so important, once you are here and you start to feel, it's affecting the next step, and that is your behavior, actions, decisions, what I call your behavior, actions, or decisions. And this is what leads to more of the same result. And so next, you see the same result actually going back into your senses, how you think about it, and then it perpetuates the same thought, the same feeling, the same behavior, action, decision that creates more of the same result, and you are stuck in this reality loop where nothing is changing, things are stagnating, it seems like things are just perpetuating or getting better, coming back, sabotaging, trying to change things, but you always seem to be coming back to the same result. And so this is in a nutshell how your mind works and why it can be so tricky to change your reality unless you understand this, unless you understand that your filters is what is the most important. And most people make the mistake of focusing here on the result. They feel like if I change my result, then I'll be okay. But they don't understand that it's those filters here that control the thoughts that they have, that control the way they think, the decision, behavior, decisions they make. So it's those filters that largely affect the result, manifestation, and things that you attract in your reality. So as long as you have the same filters, you will be perceiving the same thing in your reality. There's lack, there's not enough, I'm ugly, I don't like this, blah, blah, blah. Creating the same thought, the same feeling, the same behavior, the same old result. And so you're stuck in that reality construct that you've created for yourself. So what is the solution then? How do you make that shift that will not only change your result, but change that whole pattern that is happening subconsciously? Well, you see, where the work needs to happen, first and foremost, is in the filters. You see, it's not about you going into the external world and changing people and changing your family and changing the economy and changing who's gonna be the next president and how they're gonna help you and all that crap. That is a waste of time and is going to leave you just feeling like a victim and, you know, just really not the solution, okay? But it's exactly what the majority of people are doing, is that they're waiting for this here to change and then I'll do it. So what do you do and how do we change those filters? The challenge here with those filters is they are vastly subconscious. Carl Jung called this the shadow, is the blind spot, is what you don't see, what you don't know about yourself. So you see that subconscious filtering program that is happening without you being consciously aware of it. Most of us are just reacting to that filtering system. So we're not sure about our beliefs, our self-image, our values, the inherent, you know, belief system structures and rules that we have in place at the subconscious level that are creating and participating in the decisions and our way of perceiving reality. So the first thing really is about creating awareness here. Creating awareness to just observing the activity of your mind, just noticing how you think and how you feel toward the external world, toward your result. Because a lot of people, what they do is that they let their current result affect the way they think and feel. Yeah? So they let the current result, what is happening, create the same thought, the same feeling, the same decision, and therefore the same result. So what you can do to change those filters is to become aware, meaning conscious, and go here at the thinking and feeling level and start to think greater. I need a new pen. Start to think greater than your current environment, than the old ways of thinking that you've been programmed to think over and over and over and over again. So as you start to elevate your thoughts, and now you start to think differently, instead of being like in panic mode because, you know, your account is running low, you could be like, wait a second. What could be a better thought? Instead of me being anxious, me beating on myself, me actually going back into that panic mode, how could I think differently about myself, about my ability to generate manifest money, about my ability to find the right opportunity, about my ability to shift my reality and break that pattern once and for all? How would I think about this reality if I already had the result that I want? So if I was already making the money that I want, if I was already financially secure and safe, how would I think differently about that bill? How would I think differently about paying my next bill, paying my rent, about generating money, about how much self-worth would I have differently? So you see, I'm trying to prompt you into thinking differently, but you can do that intuitively, but that requires being grounded in the present moment, being self-aware of the automatic thought that your mind is giving and no longer buying in those thoughts. Because if you do, it's going to only reinforce the feeling and the belief and the filtering system and create the same subconscious program and reality over and over and over again. And we don't want that, right? So once you start elevating the way you think, it's going to change the way you feel, right? And another way to do that is by, you know, going to the end, visualizing, putting yourself with the right intention in the end result. And I have a lot of videos that break down the process on this channel. And so I don't want to go into the how to visualize, how to change your thoughts, how to do all those things, because otherwise we'll be here for an hour. But go on the channel, there's a lot of videos that break down exactly in different ways, different methods, how you can change your thoughts, how you can think greater, how you can use visualization or gratitude or other tools to change over time your filtering system, your subconscious belief, and in turn, your reality and your results. But really the key here is simple, is that I must become the person that think, feel, act, and behave and decide differently to create and alter my reality. You see, you cannot start your business, for example, if you want to start your business or do something, and still be afraid of putting yourself out there because you're afraid, you know, of because of that fear here that you're afraid of people will reject me, people won't love me, people will whatever people, right? And it's going to make me feel ashamed and unconscious and all that crap here. If you keep on letting those old programs, old emotions, old things from the past create the same result in your life, you just going to perpetuate that. So you gotta also be willing to work here on the red square that a lot of people don't like. It's easy to work on your thoughts and your feeling, but you also have to make the right decision. Go for it, take a chance, take that inspired action, show up in your life, show up differently, dress up differently, speak to yourself differently, set boundaries with other people, do what needs to be done, take that leap of faith in order for things to change. And a lot of people here are waiting for them to see the change, to see the thing before they take that action that they know they need to be done, before making that decision. A lot of people's problem is simply because they're not willing to make the decision because they're afraid that if I make it, I'm gonna lose, it's not gonna work, and then I'll go back to, you know, where I was, and then, you know, it's a loss, so to speak. But that version of yourself that's creating that result has already made that decision. That person, think about this, that version of yourself that lives here in that new reality is not afraid of, you know, showing themselves, putting themselves out there, making the decision that is creating the current lifestyle. And as long as you remain living in the old set of filters and thought and feeling and decisions, you will not be a match to that new reality. You will remain in your current reality, in your current pattern, simply because that's the way you choose to live. So this is, in a nutshell, what is needed for you to shift reality, for you to completely change your result. It's not about the external world, but it's about coming here and changing your self-image, changing your belief, changing those programs that are subconsciously creating those thoughts, the feeling, and the same old action, behavior, decisions that keep on creating the same old reality. Let me know, guys, what you think in the comment. Thank you for taking the time of watching this video. If you like this type of video, you want to see more videos that will help you expand your life, your results, make sure you hit that subscribe button, guys. I will see you in my next video. Be well.